we're pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
My dad never came home from the war in Korea. And so when I was 8, my grandfather gave me his job of raising the town flag each morning. Our family name, Burroughs, is on all the monuments of every war. We take our patriotism seriously in Homer. Which is why, when Dorothy Nelson returned home from the Navy in 1954, she didn't exactly get a ticker tape parade. In a small town, if you've got any secrets you can't shout out loud on the commons, maybe you should live elsewhere, a big city where your neighbors don't know your name. Homer, Connecticut was just a little too small for Dorothy Nelson.
Late.
Let me look at you.
Okay. Oh, I wish you'd worn your uniform.
I love it when the neighbors see you in it.
Have you had something to eat? Do you want me to fix you some dinner?
Mama, I desperately need to sleep. I've been on the bus for 3 days.
Well, how long can you stay?
I'm not going back. I decided to leave. For good.
But you've left the Navy. What on earth are you...
You know, let's talk about it later, please. I'm just gonna rest right now. I'm really tired. Okay, Mama?
Okay.
Sorry.
Rise and shine! Come on, get a move on! I want to see you dressed!
Guess I won't be missing Reveille. I missed home cooking. And it's so great to be able to watch television.
You never should have bought that. You were supposed to be saving for college, remember?
I thought you'd like it.
I love it. I never miss Jack Benny when he's on.
but it is extravagant. So, what do you propose? I'm sorry, but I don't earn enough to put food on the table for both of us. Well, you can't just loaf about the house all day.
I know. I'm gonna look for a job, starting today.
In this town? Most girls your age are married, raising families. They're hiring men, heads of households, veterans who've sacrificed for our country.
I sacrificed for our country.
Nobody says you haven't.
First thing I'm gonna get is a new coat for you.
First thing you're gonna do is get a job.
Welcome home, sailor.
Howdy, Mr. Burroughs. How's your grandson?
Oh, just dandy. You ought to see little Johnny raise the flag every morning, just the way his father used to. You home on liberty?
No, I'm home for good.
Say, you ought to join us at the American Legion. We've never had a girl vet before. Wouldn't that give the wives a surprise?
I just don't think that that's something that this town's quite ready for just yet. I'll see you.
Dorothy Nelson.
Mr. Manor.
I heard you were back. Of all my Bobby's girlfriends, you're still my favorite.
How is Bobby?
You know Bobby enough to make you run away and join the Navy. Look, come in the store. Let's talk like the old days.
I can't right now. I have to find a job.
For good luck.
Thank you. I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Welcome home. For the first girl from Homer to ever go naked.
Hi, Miss Keene.
Oh, please, Janet, I'm not that old. Here you go. Lunch is on the house.
Thank you, Janet.
Order's up. Hello. She is. I'll tell her. Thanks. Dorothy, that was your mother on the telephone. She wants you to go on over to the elementary school as quick as you can and report to Chuck Dawson. Seems someone just quit.
How did she know that I was here?
Where else can you eat in this town? Good luck.
This is a very good job for a young woman your age. You know, keep your hands full until you're able to have a few children of your own.
I'm your gal.
This would be nice for your mother, too. You'll be able to go to work together.
Thank you, Mr. Dawson.
Yes, lucky for both of us. Now, if I can just get a look at your discharge papers, we'll move this right along.
My discharge papers?
Hmm.
Was that really necessary?
Oh, didn't you bring them? Well, you can always go home and get them, bring them back. I'm here until 5:00.
I may have to explain a few things.
Well, no need to explain. I'm an Army man myself. Okay. There's a blue discharge.
Yes, sir.
This is a Section 8.
That can be explained.
Well, I'm sure it can, but I'm not your commanding officer. I can't hire somebody with a dishonorable discharge, and I certainly can't hire somebody with a Section 8 to work with school children. Does your mother know that you got a dishonorable discharge for this sexual deviancy?
No, sir.
Well, out of the respect that I hold for your mother, I'm going to keep this quiet just between ourselves. Good day, Dorothy.
that your father's name on the monument?
Yes.
Here's my father's.
You want to know something really neat? Whenever you really need anything, like help on a big test or good grades in school, you just come right here. You touch your father's name, and it's good luck.
It is?
Sure is. Try it sometime. I'll see you around.
See ya.
Verbatim as the legal bulwark of the Communist Party.
What a wonderful coming home present my daughter's given me. What were you thinking? Telling my I'll be lucky if I have a job after 15 years.
What does my leaving the Navy have anything to do with
it? You didn't leave the Navy. You were thrown out because you are I brought you up to be better than that. And you've disgraced me. I will not have filth and perversion in my
stay as long as you like here. Sit down. Oh. Comfy like a real bed, see?
Mr. Manos, thank you.
It's okay, that's okay.
You don't know what people are saying about me.
Who listens to people who don't know you? Say, what do you say to helping us out in the store till you land on your feet?
I would love to help out.
Ah, this whole thing will blow over. Your mama will change her mind. You'll see. You got mixed up a little bit. That's what youth is for, getting mixed up. Everything's gonna work out 100%. Dorothy, my wife needs some help up front.
Carry Mrs. Burgess's groceries to the car.
Yes, ma'am.
No, thank you. That will not be necessary.
Oh, it's no trouble.
I said that will not be necessary.
I think I'll come back later.
I'm sorry. Mrs. Dawson,
Dorothy, would you please go back to your work in the stockroom? I can handle things here.
It's no good, Dorothy. You're scaring away our regulars. You'll have to leave. I'm sorry, Dorothy, but what can I do?
I'm sorry too, Mr. Manos.
No wonder I'm 39.
Okay, there you go, son.
That's her, all right. She looks like one.
She does not. She looks perfectly normal.
She looks like a queer. Come on. What's the matter, huh? Don't you like boys? Is that it, huh?
Come on.
Go, run!
Where are you going?
Hey! Okay, stop!
Game is over.
Go home, boys.
You okay?
Yeah.
You know what? It's closing time. I was gonna have a drink. Would you care to join me?
Yes.
You look like you could use one. Come on.
Thank you.
Okay. So, what happened? Did you want out, or did they want you out?
It's funny. Nobody else in this town has even bothered asking me that.
Well, why ask when you can gossip?
Does everybody think that I'm...
a lesbian? Are you?
I don't know. You know, I never even knew that there was such a thing until I signed up. That was the first time that I'd even thought about it.
Sleeping Beauties, hit the decks, it's 0500. I want your butts showered and dressed and the entire company mustered in 10 minutes. Let's go! Move it, ladies!
Hey, miss! Hey, slow down! Come join us! Leslie! Lesbo! Is that why you joined up, for a little shower activity?
Even if enlisted men call you names, you will behave like ladies at all times. It is normal to form close friendships with other women in the Navy, which may last beyond the service. This is normal behavior. But lesbianism must be eradicated from our ranks. If you know of or suspect any such behavior, you will report it to me promptly. I will not brook such behavior. Not
when you're
on
told
my
week
watch.
After week that you mustn't think of something. Soon that's all you can think of.
Hey, scholar, why don't you get your nose out of that book? There are just two ways a girl can go blind: reading and jerking off.
And I did wonder why I'd never fallen in love with a man.
Put it back in your pants, girls. You just earned yourselves a Section 8.
And then the Navy started cracking down. More and more waves were getting drummed out just on the suspicion of being lesbian. One rumor was all it took. They could have come for me at any second. So just imagine my relief when I met this wonderful man. I knew one thing for certain. I had never met anyone like Billy Temple in this man's Navy.
Chief Petty Officer Billy Temple requesting permission to address Lieutenant Commander Pat McPherson on the urgent matter of how to train waves. On proper bedpan techniques.
Yes, sir.
Now, you don't have to tell the old gal exactly what I said. She is watching us, though.
Yes, sir.
Dorothy. Dorothy? Is your name really Dorothy? Dorothy as in, I don't think we're in Kansas anymore, Dorothy? Tell me something, Dorothy. Do you like the movies?
Yes, I do.
Well, how'd you like to join me at 1900 in the mess tonight? The show and stage door.
Oh, I love new movies.
Oh, child. Child, I can see Cousin Billy's gonna have to take you in hand. Stage door is a classic. Stage door illuminates human existence. Stage door is free. 1900. I'll see you there. Seaman Nelson, I'm so glad you came. Sit down. Allow me to introduce my gang of hospital corpsmen. They're quite a rowdy crew. Ray, Tony, this is my friend Dorothy.
Pleased to meet
Dorothy,
you.
Dorothy, delighted. You know, I'm a friend of Dorothy's.
And I'm a friend of Dorothy's.
Watch it, clowns. You see, we call ourselves the friends of Dorothy because
we just love the Wizard of Oz, don't you?
From the beginning, I really liked Billy. He was sweet and kind of shy. He certainly wasn't like any of the boys in Homer.
No, I guess that's a blessing, huh?
Yeah, blessing in disguise, perhaps. I saw a lot of Billy in the weeks to come. He was just so charming and funny. What about you? Why did he join up?
Oldest cliche there is. Won the Navy to make a man out of me.
Did you ever see any action?
Oh, yeah. Got myself a Purple Heart and everything. It makes for a good pickup line, if nothing else. You know, why don't you come up to my place and see my Purple Heart?
Well, Billy, I hope you don't think that this is too forward of me. I would love to come to your place and see your Purple Heart.
Dorothy, you're a sweet kid and everything, but don't be getting a crush on your old cousin, Billy.
Would that be so terrible?
Yes, I'm afraid it would be.
Why?
Boy, you see, I'm not like other men.
That's why I'm crazy about you.
Listen, Dorothy, I care about you. If I could fall in love with you, I would. I wish I could. But all I can ever be is your friend. I'm a friend of Dorothy's. That's a code name for men like me. I'm homosexual. I thought you knew that.
I'm such a fool. Oh.
Dorothy, no, you're not at all. But listen, if you even breathe one word of this to your CO after 10 years of service, I am out with no benefits.
Don't worry, you can trust me, Billy. Don't worry.
I know I can. Dorothy, I hope this doesn't offend you, but, I think maybe you got a crush on me for a reason. You see, I always thought you liked me because you were like me.
You mean a friend of Dorothy's?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Oh, come on. You have thought about it, haven't you? Sure you have.
Yes. Yeah, Billy, I have.
And you did join the Navy for adventure, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think you're up for some?
Mm-hmm.
Good girl. Then I'll show you the time of your life. You meet me downtown, 1900 hours, and wear your civvies. Where we're going, it's best not to advertise you're a swabby.
Only you and you alone. Yeah, we'll meet like you do.
Sorry. I've never seen so many.
What? Men dancing with men? Women dancing with women? Colored people dancing with whites? Ruby owns this place. Most of these places are in the colored part of town. Colored people know what it is to live and let live. Sit down. Can I get a couple of scotches here for me and my friend? Dorothy, this is Ruby.
Welcome to Ruby's, Dorothy. You letting this man lead you astray? Now, don't you worry. Everybody here is real ladies and gentlemen. It's just that sometimes they clothes don't match.
Thank you, Ruby. Now listen, the bouncer sits over there by the door. The first sign of trouble, or if someone comes in that he doesn't know, he flips a switch. Now you see that light over there? Mm-hmm. It's It's important to watch that light while you're dancing. If that light goes on, you grab me or the man nearest to you and start dancing, okay?
Relax. This place almost never gets raided.
Ruby pays for her protection regularly. Come on, I got the first dance. Oh, you see that? Red light just came on. Must be someone the bouncer didn't know came in. Ooh, just some old bull dagger coming in from the cold.
Oh my God. Billy, it's McPherson, my CO. I think she just saw me. We gotta get out of here.
Whoa, darling. Take it easy there. You might have just had a stroke of good fortune. See, if she knows you saw her come in, she's not gonna say anything. You might even get a promotion out of this.
Billy, let's go.
Hey, would you relax? We're supposed to be having a good time now.
Who's that?
Oh, that? That's just Max.
Max?
Well, really, it's Maxine.
Mind if I cut in?
Oh, not at all.
I mean you, honey.
I'm sure she'd be delighted. Max, take care of her, won't you? Excuse me.
Don't tell me you've never done this.
Done what?
Dance with a woman before? There's something else you've never done with a woman.
What?
So fast after that. I don't know how long I was interrogated.
Witnesses have testified that you were seen engaging in intimate behavior with a woman.
We danced.
You don't remember the names of any other enlisted personnel in the bar?
No. You could trust me. I don't remember anyone else.
We're not going to get much more.
Lieutenant, I really do think it was her first time in the bar. It falls to your discretion to overlook a first-time offense.
Get rid of her.
Yes, ma'am. Sign here where indicated on all copies. It's a Section 8 discharge, effective immediately.
What's gonna happen to Billy?
Court-martial. Hard labor for not cooperating with our investigation and for corrupting enlisted personnel.
One stroke of the pen, and there went my college tuition, my pension, my future.
Rubbish. You can put yourself through college with no thanks to Uncle Sam.
I can't even find a job with my discharge papers.
True, not in Homer, but... Dorothy, listen. If you fell in love tomorrow, got married, and had 5 children, people in this town would still whisper every time you left the room. Small towns don't forgive or forget.
What am I gonna do?
Well, the only place I know where you can just be a face in the crowd and not treated like an outcast is New York City.
New York?
Nobody's gonna ask for your discharge papers in Greenwich Village. Listen, I've got a friend, Bev Mayer. She lives in the village. She's got a big heart for strays. If you want, I can give her a call.
Okay.
I can give her a call right now. You finish your eggs.
Okay. Thanks, Janet.
Says that she would be happy to give you the use of her sofa for a week, which should give you enough time to find yourself a room. There's her phone number and her address.
Were you two?
We were roommates. Very good friends. We still are. Let's just leave it at that.
Janet, I don't know if I am a lesbian.
Well, you're not going to find out in this town. Listen, Dorothy. If you are a lesbian, become an extraordinary one. I want you to take this.
No.
Yes. To help you get started in your new life.
I can't. This is...
It's not a gift. It's a loan. Many years ago, I found myself in a really bad situation. And a woman gave me a very generous sum, which saved me. And she told me she didn't want me to pay her back. But instead that... when I could afford... She wanted me to help out some promising young woman. Some young woman who found herself in trouble, too. So there. I've paid my debt. You do the same.
Yes, ma'am.
It's late.
I'm tired. You take the sofa and get the bus in the morning.
Nelson, I'm sorry to hear about your daughter being in trouble.
I don't have a daughter.
That was the last time Dorothy Nelson was in Homer, except for the day of her mother's funeral. My granddad told me never to get mixed up with her kind. But I thought she looked nice, and she looked worried. So I rubbed her father's name for her, to bring her good luck, wherever she was going. Whoa. Oh, mercy, mercy me. Some things seemed to never change. So when my time came, I went to war, like my father, and his father before him.
You don't want to get it all tangled up.
Grampy never let me help him. He said this was a boy's job.
In his day it was. There. Pull it down and unclip that sign. Got it? Okay, now stand tall. Don't want to let it touch the ground.
Is that like a sin if it touches?
It's more of a sign of disrespect. We show how we love our country by how we handle our flag.
I was lucky enough to survive. I returned to Homer, looking for peace in my own life and in the world around me.
What about those people on television who burn the flag?
Well, it's a free country.
Do you hate them?
Honey, I don't have time to hate anybody.
Even when you were at Vietnam?
Especially when I was in Vietnam.
Ballet class.
Well, give me that end. There, you see? That makes a nice triangle. And tell your mother I'll be a little late for supper tonight, okay? A little behind on my flower boxes. Bye-bye.
Mr. Roberts. Hi.
Hi.
Voulez vous coucher avec moi, Mr. Roberts?
Well, you know, I'd love to, Peggy, but I don't think my girlfriend would like it very much. And how many times do I have to tell you it's pronounced Robert, Robert? The T and the S are silent. Mr. Roberts was a movie. I'm your French teacher. A demain.
I told you I had a girlfriend. Toby, do you want to study together tonight?
Sorry, I can't, Peggy. Monsieur Robert,
Why can't anybody else pronounce my name correctly, huh? Hey, Toby, if this is about a grade, this isn't exactly office hours.
It's not about a grade.
No, of course not. You're my best student. Oops, shouldn't have said that. I didn't say it, and you didn't hear it. Well, okay, shoot. Do with the school board, but if it's important.
It can wait.
Why, are you sure? You okay, Toby?
Can I ask you something? I mean, do you...
What am I want?
Well, you know, everybody says you're gonna be principal of the school next year.
Well, if I'm not too late for this meeting, maybe I will be.
I'm gonna be late for swim practice. A bientôt, Professor Robert.
Au revoir, mon ami.
Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir, Toby?
Oh, je veux coucher avec Monsieur Roberts, hein?
Hey, Toby, how do you say 69 in French?
Sure wish my daddy would buy me a $15,000 toy.
Yeah, Toby, when are you gonna paint it a pretty pink?
Leave him alone, guys.
Queer with a girlfriend. Amazing.
I'm not his girlfriend, Jimmy.
And I am not...
What? Look, you can't even say it.
You guys are being ridiculous.
Come on, Toby, practice. We got that big meet with Bridgeport.
Yeah, you can sneak some more looks at people's dicks.
Yeah, he's got a lot of practice at that.
Why don't you practice this?
No way, Jose.
Come on, guys, we got practice.
What we do to queers and Homer.
Out of my commons, you don't.
What, are you his boyfriend?
Get out of here, Jimmy Allen, before I call your mother.
Just wait, Anderson.
I said beat it.
So why'd you help me?
I don't like seeing people fight, especially in front of the memorial. It's disrespectful. Not too many people come to read those war dead names anymore.
I wouldn't die for this country.
They didn't die for this country. They died because they believed in something.
Yeah, and look what you got for it. Sorry. I was out of line.
I believe in my family. I believe in our way of life here. That's enough.
You wouldn't believe in anything if you were me.
You want to talk about it?
Why does everybody act like I have something to talk about?
I had some at home. You go on, it'll put some hair in your chest. Very funny. Could you imagine a place like this in Homer? You'd be the only customer. Well, we wouldn't have to drive halfway across the state just to get a drink.
Okay, what is going on with you? Why are you doing this? Talk to me.
I actually do have to talk to you.
Something bad happened at school today.
Oh, you fell in love with another teacher. It happens all the time.
Oh.
I have the senior, Toby Anderson. He's my best student. He's every teacher's best student. He's varsity state swimming champion. He plays the hell out of the piano, this kid.
So do Van Cliburn and Liberace. Can we cut to the chase here?
I think he's gay, and I'm pretty sure he wanted to come out to me.
That's great. That's wonderful. That means he trusts you.
That means he thinks I'm gay.
Well, I don't know how to break this to you, darling, but you are.
Have you taken a look around you? What did you do?
Nothing. I couldn't handle it. He's going to Harvard in the fall. Let him come out in Cambridge, not in Homer.
Well, I would take it as an enormous compliment if one of my students wanted to come out to me.
Yes, well, you're not about to be made high school principal.
Yes, I know, honey, but if we don't step up and be counted, what can we expect from their
generation? Next generation, right, fine.
This, I love Homer. I love teaching, uh-huh. I love my life mm-hmm. there, I love you.
Right, Gil, you love everyone and everything but yourself.
That's not fair, this isn't New York City. This is not Stonewall.
Give me a break, Gil. He's a kid.
What the hell are you afraid of?
Do you mind if I dance with your boyfriend?
Well, at this moment, he doesn't have a boyfriend. I'm sorry, I came here to have fun tonight.
Et pour demain, nous verrons qui a...
What is it that's so burning that it cannot wait, Monsieur Alain?
How do you say homosexual in French?
Why, are you planning to meet one or be one?
Well, I'm just planning on beating the merit out of one if he doesn't stop looking at me all the time.
Well, if it were up to me, the only students who would have the merit beat out of them are the ones who are full of it, such as yourself. And on that note, I'll see you all tomorrow.
What's the word?
You're a big boy. Look it up.
He meant me.
Yes, I figured that.
Why? You think I'm gay, too?
I didn't say that, Toby.
You know, a bunch of them are after me.
Well, have you reported them?
No. And I don't want you to.
Well, I'd be failing you as your teacher if I didn't.
I can take care of myself.
Yes, but to persecute another boy just because they think that he's a homosexual, it's wrong. It's disgusting.
It sounds like it happened to you.
Well, almost. I played Juliet back in prep school. And opening night, I had a black eye because they all thought that I was gay. As it happens, it was our Mercutio who liked the boys. This too shall pass, Toby, believe me.
I think I am a homosexual, Monsieur Aubert.
At your age?
No, it's not about my age. I'm 18, I start college in the fall. I've been to Europe twice on my own. I think about this nearly all the time. No, in fact, I think about it all the time. I hardly think about anything else.
I really don't think we should be having this conversation.
Well, if I can't have it with you, who should I be having it with?
I don't know what you mean.
Sorry. Thought you were somebody I could talk to. Wrong again, Toby.
Well, I'm sorry I'm not what you think I am.
Thanks a lot, Teach.
Hey, man, this is not fair.
Come on, see what you got. You ain't got it.
Jay, come on. Come on, let you in.
Hey, Jimmy, I hear you have a new French word in your vocabulary.
Homosexuel.
Êtes-vous un homosexuel, Denny?
No, but I have one standing right beside
What's
me.
What's the French word for blowjob?
Le blowjob.
Mr. Roberts knows all those queer French words.
Because he is one.
Hey, Toby, you want to donnez-moi un blowjob?
Guys, cool it. Coach is coming.
You know why those boys from Stanford are going to be the next state champions and not you? They're a team. They'll win as a team because they work as a team. Now, I'm ordering you to like one another until the meet. After that, you can kill each other. Now, let's have practice. Toby, they're just boys.
So am I.
Well, they didn't mean it.
Yes, they did.
Look, I'm way out of bounds doing this, but here's a phone number I'm gonna give you. Her name is Laura. She'll make a man out of you, I promise.
Toby! This time we do have a study date.
Something came up. I can't.
What is wrong with you, Toby?
Nothing a good piece of ass won't cure.
It's disgusting.
It probably sounds better in French.
We don't have to do this, you know.
Yes, we do.
Who says?
I do.
You don't have to prove anything to me.
I'm proving something to myself.
You don't sound very convinced.
I'm sorry.
There's nothing to be sorry about.
Half the time, that coach of yours can't even... Oh, I shouldn't tell tales out of school.
You were just nervous.
Wait till I get my hands on that son of a bitch.
You think I'm gay, don't you?
Do you think you're gay? I don't know. Being gay is not the end of the world. It doesn't even make you special. It's just something else about you. You still have to wake up like everybody else and brush your teeth and try to get through another day just like every other human being.
Make it sound so easy. Wish everybody was like that.
We bring home the school's first state championship in 15 years. Now, come on, let's do it. Come on, let's go.
Men's 4x100 freestyle relay. Swimmers to your blocks.
Go out there and do it, man.
Do it! Toby!
for all of us.
He threw the race, Coach.
The hell do you think you're doing? You're off the team.
I'll rip his head off.
You hear me, Toby? You're off the team! Say goodbye to any college you ever thought of going to. No one talks to this one, you got that? He is off the team. From this moment on, he doesn't exist. His swimming records don't exist. He is, pardon my French, a piece of shit. And I'll personally kill anyone who claims I ever said that. I trusted you. I believed in you. I even tried to help you. This is my thanks, huh? Gentlemen, this is a sight to be pitied. A grown man weeping. Well, almost a grown man. And maybe not even a real one at that.
Let me out of Colt.
Can it, Denny. You're still on school property. All right, everybody, hit the showers. Come on, get the hell out of here.
Have you seen Toby?
No. No, no one's come out yet.
Why would he do something like that?
It's just what I'm waiting to ask him.
Get the fag.
Get him.
All right,
hold him down!
Come on,
get over here!
This is for the championship.
I'll shut him up.
What are you doing?
It's none of your fucking business!
Denny,
you stand guard, all right?
Jimmy, what are you doing? Are you crazy? I'll give you what you want.
Is Toby Anderson still in there? Is he in there?
I don't know.
Well, if you don't go in there, I will.
Toby?
Someone's coming. It's Robert.
Where's Toby? Toby?
You telling us? We'll tell everyone we caught you two doing it.
He's not gonna say anything.
Yeah, he's the biggest fag as the other one is.
Happens to faggots in Homer, Connecticut.
They're not gonna get away with this, Toby. I know who they are.
And they know who I am. It's too bad you don't know who you are, Mr. Robert.
I have asked for this time tonight in order to announce my answer to the House Judiciary Committee's subpoena for additional Watergate tapes.
I'd rather have his problems.
Finally! Oh my God, the great Sphinx has spoken.
I don't know what I'm gonna do.
You don't know what to do.
These actions will at last.
Well, let's see. Let's see. I've got a liar and a hypocrite in the White House, and I've got one right here in Homer. Only here's the thing, here's the one big difference. I'm not in love with Richard Nixon. He's not the man that I was expecting to spend the rest of my life with.
It's not that simple.
Yes, it is. It is that simple. It's who you are. It's who you are right down to your fingertips. If you don't stand up and be counted this time, Gil, you'll never stand up and be counted.
It's not that simple, Gus.
Go to hell.
About the fact that the president has nothing to hide in this matter.
You know what? I cannot believe that for 6 years, I've been in love with a coward.
Resort. It is the most solemn act of our entire...
Monsieur Alain?
Merci.
Mademoiselle Breverman?
Merci.
Monsieur Schussmann? Yes, what is it, Jimmy?
Monsieur Anderson, malade, Mr. Roberts. Il didn't come to class aujourd'hui.
Mademoiselle Flanagan?
Toby est très malade.
Monsieur Frank?
Toby est très, très malade.
Do you know the French word for cowardly or vile, Monsieur Alain? It's lâche. Lâche. Would you say it for me, please?
Lâche.
Oh, you can say it better. Louder than that, can't you? Let me put it in a sentence. Je suis lâche. I'm a vile coward. Say it, please.
Je suis lâche.
No? I still can't hear it. Can you, class? Perhaps if Messieurs Tate, Carter, and Langer would say it with you. Nous sommes lâches. Say it, please.
Nous sommes lâches.
No. See, I think you'd be able to say it better if I told you more precisely what the word means. Lâche means bullying. Four against one. It means hatred for anybody who is not like you. It means you're threatened by someone's sexuality because you are so uncertain of your own. It means Monsieur Anderson is not with us here today because you think you have the right to tell him who he is. It means Toby was beaten by four bigots for being honest about who he is. While I am being talked up as this school's next principal, precisely because I have never been honest about who I am with anyone, most of all myself. So, in an effort to be somewhat less lâche, I've decided to report the four young boys who did this to the police and the school authorities. Yesterday you asked me the French for a word. Monsieur Alain, did you look it up?
No, sir.
The word was, I believe, homosexual.
Yes, sir.
Well, let me put it in a good French sentence. Je suis homosexuel. Moi, Monsieur Gilles Robert, je suis homosexuel. Does anybody have a problem with that? Anybody at all?
Good. Good.
Now, let's get on with the business of learning the glorious French language. We might even think about getting on with our lives.
Well? I guess that's what they mean by cutting off your nose to spite your face.
You're still the best swimmer in the state.
Nobody will know it now.
I'll know. You'll know.
Toby? Oh, sorry.
I'll call you.
Am I interrupting something?
No, really, it's fine. He needs to talk to you.
Thank you.
be in class tomorrow. I haven't killed myself yet.
I hope that's a joke. If it is, it's a bad one.
Why? Save everyone else the trouble. Don't worry. I wouldn't give them the satisfaction.
It doesn't have to be this way, you know.
How would you know?
Because I've been there, that's why.
Oh, really? You could have fooled me. You're not a very good role model, Monsieur Robert.
Yeah, I know. I should have told you first. I let you down. I let myself down. Can you forgive me?
I thought you wanted to be made principal.
I do, but not at this price.
You know, they're not going to let you teach.
I'm okay with that, really. You don't want my pity, I don't want yours.
Well, you say it doesn't have to be this way. So how's it going to be, Monsieur Robert?
Well, what do you want to know?
Do people ever stop hating you?
I don't think some of them can.
Why?
It's a good question. I don't know.
So what do you do?
Well, up until now, nothing. Today was a baby step.
And tomorrow?
Another baby step.
I feel like taking 50 giant steps.
I believe you will.
What's it feel like to make love to another man?
It's wonderful.
See, that's what I want to learn.
Well, you have to find the right person first.
Have you?
Yes, I have. His name is Gus, and I love him. We have 6 years together, and when he holds me, I feel safe and at home.
You think I'll ever find anyone like that?
Well, everybody asks those questions, Toby. Even straight people. We spend our whole lives trying to answer them. Thank you. Best part about being a teacher is how much you're taught.
Well, maybe I'll teach, Monsieur Robert.
No, from now on it's pronounced Roberts. I don't know who I thought I was kidding. Robert.
All right.
Roberts.
You need some help with that?
Thanks.
There.
Don't let it touch the ground. Thought you were off to Harvard.
Ah, 2 more weeks.
You gonna set Cambridge, Mass on fire?
Well, I'll just be happy if I can find a boyfriend.
You know, Toby, I like you. I always have, but that kind of talk's gonna take some getting used to.
I know.
I ever tell you some crank called my wife and told her he'd seen us together?
Sorry.
Small town. Smaller minds. You think he's gonna get his job back?
He's sure gonna fight. Got the best lawyer in the state.
Well, times, they are a-changing.
Yeah. Even in Homer, Connecticut.
Well, Toby, you take care of yourself. Change never comes easy, but still, it always comes, one way or another. Who would have guessed that Mr. Roberts and his friend Gus would stay together, right there in Homer, for the rest of their lives, a loving, happily unmarried couple? He got his job back, but never was made principal. And Toby, after he graduated from Harvard with honors and a degree in classical studies, took a position with the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York City. He doesn't come home much. I can't say I blame him. Homer grew bigger. I grew older. And change comes for better and for worse. I've heard good people say that we learn prejudice, that bigotry wouldn't exist if it weren't taught us. You think that's true? I believe hating is something we were given to overcome. We just don't seem willing to admit that about ourselves. We seem to always concentrate on our uncommon ground. More puzzling, it's often our commonality that we choose as the borderline. Two men can love God equally, but if they worship differently, they are enemies. Now, if devotion to a higher power turns neighbors into strangers, how can loving each other be any less trouble?
The sun rose after all. Who would have believed it?
People fuss, world turns. Who would have believed it? Think that corsage might be a little showy for a Sunday?
Oh, have I got a funny father. I'm on the Rainbow Balloon Committee. Red was my assignment.
Oh.
Lisa's bringing the yellow, Maggie gets the blue. Stacy pulled violet, though I think the fix was in on that one.
Who's bringing the black ones?
Black balloons for a wedding. Nice dad.
You don't ask, you don't learn.
I know they'll have enough food there to feed a small army, but you should still have a piece of fruit and some cereal to hold you through the ceremony. I should live so long. Ira.
Now, how'd I know you'd go for a bluish red instead of a yellow red?
Never send a woman to do a queen's job.
A theory proved daily by Martha Stewart.
The place looks great.
Well, what on earth can't be fixed with glitter feathers and a string of lights?
Oh, look, it's the cake.
Oh, I want to see. Oh, since they've been fucking for 20 years, don't you think that white is a little naive, even in a small town?
Well, said the politically correct lesbian caterer to the embarrassingly stereotypical, but I suppose necessary fag florist. Can we discuss this after we put the cake down?
You know, for a cake like that, I'd marry Frankie tomorrow.
You already married him.
Yeah, if only I knew then what I know now.
They're actually going through with it. Assholes.
Only two of them.
Yeah, for now, the rest are probably just late. You know, straight people are always late. You know, SPT. Straight people time.
Maybe they'll forget.
You ever notice how straight men see everything as a war? I mean, football, hockey, driving, politics, sex, it's all the same to them. They choose up sides and they attack. And they like it even better if they get to wear a little uniform.
Well, my dad swore it's going to be a silent, non-intrusive, respectful protest.
A silent, non-intrusive, respectful protest of a wedding? Just a bunch of kids playing G.I. Joe.
What about you know who? You hear anything?
You mean Ira, father of the bride?
He wouldn't. He couldn't.
He would, he could, he just might.
Oh. Where's a nice cyclone or twister when you need one?
This is New England, darling. The only thing that blows hard here are nor'easters and elected officials, which may explain our love of politics.
It's my wedding, and I'll sleep if I want to.
I'm sorry to bother you, darling. It's Ira. He's gone, with his uniform. I thought all this was settled last night when I stopped talking to him. But obviously, he's not going to be happy until he gives me a stroke.
Okay, hold on. Here, your father's gone AWOL. AWOL or MIA. Amos? Amos?
Amos?
Sweetheart, I can't.
Are you
so
sorry.
Hello, Andy.
Yes, Claire.
Hello. I'm really worried about him.
What are you doing clowning around here in that getup? Ain't you got a wedding to go to?
Beatrice Rosen, keep your nose out of what it don't belong in.
I'm only talking.
So talk to yourself.
I do. And whoever listens does so at his own risk. To miss your child's wedding is something not easily forgotten or forgiven by anyone ever. Trust me. Rodney and I are going over just as soon as we're done with the breakfast rush. We're gonna dance.
Enjoy yourself.
Keep your money. Ira, go home and change. He's your boy. He's a good boy. They're both good boys.
Beatrice, what'd I tell you?
If you didn't listen, you wouldn't hear so much.
Hi, Ira.
Father!
Good morning.
Good morning. Running a little late, aren't you, Father?
Oh, I'm ministering last rites for Mrs. Brandt at the Hope.
Oh, that's too bad. Nice lady.
Aren't you fellows headed in the wrong direction for morning services?
You gotta do what you gotta do.
You'll be having your say from the pulpit, and we'll be having ours from the street.
You are gonna say something about this mess, aren't you?
You think I should?
Well, last I heard, the church had plenty to say about homosexuals. So, you gonna let them have it?
I tell you, gentlemen, there's an interesting question raised with all of this. We condemn the homosexual for a lifestyle that rejects God's holy union of marriage, yes?
Correct.
But then, when he seeks to join the fold, we condemn him for that as well. Seems to me to be a no-win situation.
But that's what the church says, doesn't it?
And God.
Same thing.
You sure?
Sure.
If only I was so sure.
Hey, fellas.
What's in the bag?
Field rations.
Oh, public drinking. I wanted to go put it back in the trunk.
I got my van right across the street. Let's say we take a short at ease.
You got it, Tommy. Let's do it. Let's go.
Catering's what you ask for, catering's what you get.
I'm impressed.
Just doing what lesbians do best.
Cooking? Hauling heavy shit in a van. Here, give us a hand.
Oh!
How'd you find me?
I wasn't looking.
What are you doing here?
Trying to have my coffee without answering questions. You don't have a rifle in that thing or anything, do you? Why aren't you home?
Why aren't you down there with your friends?
I got time. So that's how they prepare that dish. I always wondered.
Doesn't matter. It's off anyway. I mean, that is what you want, isn't it? Cancel the fucking thing?
Watch your mouth. After all, I'm your father.
I'm a little old for that, no?
You think so? I'll let you know that my father... No, my father was already dead by the time I was your age. But my mother... Did you know that she's coming? Your grandmother? Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise. Huh? Did you know your Aunt Joan is bringing her?
No.
Surprise! What the hell am I supposed to know? Nobody's talked to me in weeks. You're a pain in the ass, you know that?
Remember last summer when Andy and I fished that lake in Vermont? And I told you that I'd never be able to find it again? Well, I think I'm gonna go prove myself right.
Does anyone else know?
No.
You're just not gonna show up?
Isn't that what you want?
You wanna stop saying that?
What is it that you think you're doing down there?
We're making a statement. You could have had your thing at home. You could have done it at your house. I begged you to do it at our house. Nobody would have cared.
Neither was big enough for the party.
A homosexual wedding is not a party.
I think that depends upon the band you hire.
Amos, call your mother. And somebody better have been off buying somebody else a fabulous gift.
Plastic. Can't argue with practicality. Sterilized, too.
I thought you were Amos.
Oh, we can play it that way if you want. But frankly, I don't think either of our spouses will fall for it.
What is that mood for? And better yet, what is that vial for?
Don't make me beg.
I thought we finished this month on Friday.
This whole homeo-homo rhythm method thing is not an exact science. I was on my way to CVS to pick up the EPTs, and I thought, wouldn't it be trippy if the baby was conceived on your special day?
Hmm. Well, it's Amos's turn.
And he is?
Don't know.
I left my girlfriend at home on a warm mattress with a turkey baster. He's gone, you're here. Teach that one-eyed weasel who's boss.
Is that what you're like in bed?
You ever look at that war memorial down there? It's got the names of every hometown kid from the Revolutionary War to Vietnam. A lot of people consider this to be sacred ground.
No one's throwing an orgy. This is a wedding.
It's a judgment call. That's all I'm saying it is. Why else have a town committee to decide these things?
The committee decided, yes.
Without consulting veterans groups. It's a question of respect.
Who's being disrespectful?
If you're going to ask questions that you know all the answers to, neither one of us is going to learn anything.
Well, if each of us thinks he knows the answer, then one of us should have the guts to say it.
Because you're homosexuals! Happy? I've got no problem saying it. This government had no problem saying it. Why else do you think the army has that? Don't say nothing. I don't want to know policy.
Dad, I think that's Mom's policy on skydiving and recreational drugs. The government has don't ask, don't tell, don't pursue.
Don't pursue? What the hell does that mean?
Are you going to go down there and stand with them?
Hey, how you doing? Show these prickly men business, eh?
Well, now we're talking.
Real men here.
We had a meeting. We discussed it. We took a vote. They're my friends.
I'm your son.
I've known them longer.
I think we should at least report a missing person.
But which one?
I know where my husband is.
Amos will be there, Claire. I don't know why he left. I don't know where he is. I don't know what he's thinking. But I do know Amos. He'll be there.
Did you bring me a scone? I meant to tell you.
Well, how about better than that?
I know that face. Someone's got a Jones on.
Forget it, we have a wedding ticket. I have Devon cream. Honey. Mm-hmm.
black currant jam. Mm. Oh, yeah. Little something extra that makes all this a noble effort.
Why didn't you just say it's for the boys?
Oh, yeah, okay. It's for the boys.
Mm-hmm. Well, better late than infertile.
Ah, reinforcements.
Who is that? Can you see?
It's the Catholic Church.
It's not the church, it's just the people.
I'm sorry, Mr. Goldman, but OJ didn't kill your son. It was the loss of blood.
The Bible says what the Bible says. It's right there in black and white. You can't argue with that.
Sure I can. You want the lecture? Fine. Leviticus, it says that it is an abomination for one man to lie with another as if with a woman. Yes, it says that in black and white.
Finally, some sense.
But it also says just two pages back that it's an abomination to eat shrimp. It's also an abomination to eat lobster. It's the same damnable abomination to eat pork. So yes, Dad, according to your Bible, the road to hell is paved with bacon. So I'll make you a deal. You take the sausage out of your mouth, and I'll take the sausage out of mine.
Don't be so fresh.
You know, sometimes I think that when I die, people will stand over my open grave and argue if I ever had the right to live.
Yours is a lifestyle that not everyone understands.
Moving to a golf condo in Boca Raton is a lifestyle. Being gay is a life. Does a dog live the lifestyle of a dog or a dog's life?
Enough lecturing already. Class dismissed. Good. I mean, gee, you try to make a simple comment and... I don't want you to be a homosexual.
I'm sorry, Dad. You don't get a vote.
Not what I wanted for my only son. Sue me. But I don't think I've been so terrible about it either. You, on the other hand, could have done so much better. Sending us to New York City with tickets to the play where the homosexual broke the news to his mother. Hey, what were you thinking? Huh? Your poor mother cried all the way home.
You know, Andy and I had been living together for 5 years when we gave you those tickets. You would have had to have been blind.
You were roommates. That's what you told us. That's what I told people. So, I was blind. When I was in the army in my platoon for a while, there was a queer... That's what we called him back then. I wasn't friendly with him or anything. Nobody was. But some of the guys you'd hear now and again would let him do things. On Monday, they'd let him do things. Then on Tuesday, they'd beat the living snot out of him. That's the way it was. That's what I thought a queer was. I didn't hate him. I didn't pity him. I didn't care. And after we came back, I went through the list of the injured, missing, the dead, and I saw this guy's name, killed in action. And I thought, good for him. He's better off.
You suppose that somewhere out there there's a war memorial with his name on it? And do you suppose they'd let us have the wedding there?
We're gonna have to take the back road to avoid Main Street. I hear it's a circus in town. And here come the clowns. Sondheim, forgive.
Whoever hired these bartenders has my eternal gratitude. Before this evening is over, I want to die with that one on my face.
Why can't you just say he's cute?
Why does everything have to be such a drama with you?
Wherever there are boys who do not appreciate their youth, and men who do, there will be drama.
Do you think anyone is going to have the nerve to come in?
I'll go get him.
You look beautiful, Andy. If Amos doesn't show up, I'll marry you myself.
Well, now there's one we've never seen on Jerry Springer.
You should be proud of yourself. They never would have had the balls to carry it this far without your approval.
I told you I hadn't planned it this way, I'd be lying. But I expected to enjoy it more.
Are you really that mad at me?
Let's go. There's enough fooling around.
Put down your cowl, Batman. I'm not going anywhere.
What are you talking about? Let's go.
Yeah. Go down. You do what you have to do. I gotta go.
But I think I forgave you.
I'll see you later, Dad. Talk to you in a few weeks.
You're not gonna let a few guys scare you off, are you? Come on. They're not gonna touch you.
You think I'm scared of them?
Then where are you going?
I can't do it.
What, the wedding?
Yes, the wedding. I can't get married. It's just, it's not for me. I'm sorry.
You're kidding me, right?
Right.
You are scared.
Of what, of them?
Oh, forget them. Marriage. You're scared of marriage.
What?
Oh, this is so cute. You've got the wedding day jitters.
Cut it out.
Oh, this is so cute.
Would you stop saying that?
It's all right. Everyone has wedding day jitters.
I don't have the jitters.
Why all of a sudden are you running away from home?
I have been thinking about this for a long time now.
Then why don't you tell anyone?
I wasn't sure yet.
Well, what are you telling me? Are you through with Andy?
No, I'm not through with Andy.
Uh-huh. So you're through with the town?
I'm through with you. That's what I'm through with. I'm through with you.
This is wonderful. This is one of those father-son things I was sure I'd missed out on.
Would you please leave me alone?
Listen, it's normal. Perfectly normal. I had them too. You should have seen me. Worse than you. You got bigger balls than me. Yeah, I just laid on the bed and shook until they came and dragged me off to the altar. Some of those same guys that you see waiting down there now. Oh, son, look at you. You're normal.
Dad, I worked my whole life to prove that I'm as good as anybody else. And what's happened? I've turned out just like everybody else. I mean, I'm a gay man in a heterosexual world, and that hardly seems to matter anymore.
You've lost me now.
I've been in a monogamous relationship longer than 83% of American marriages. Our house is paid off. I own my own business. We have two cars, a pickup truck. Andy is on his second career. We've been to Disneyland twice, Disney World three times. We went to Euro Disney for our 15th anniversary. Think about this. Congress passes a law against gays getting married. We are having our wedding ceremony at a community center, thrown by a town committee with the blessings of the town fathers.
With protesters. Give yourself a little credit.
Dad, this is a town of 27,000 people. If that is all the outrage they could muster, it's embarrassing.
You know, I come from a labor family. I'm not all that comfortable on this side of a picket line.
I mean, I'm supposed to be a gay man. You know what that means. You read, I'm supposed to be having all this wild, promiscuous sex with thousands of partners. You know how many men I've slept with?
Oh, geez, son.
Three, and two of those were before I was 20. I mean, where are my thousands? Where are my discos and my parties, my sad and pathetic and lonely life? And what's going to happen when we have the baby? Carpooling, soccer mommying, PTA meetings.
You've got my attention now.
Yes. As if we aren't heterosexual-esque enough. A friend of ours volunteered to surrogate a baby for us. We're gonna be parents.
Well, you can hold your head high on that one, Amos. That's not normal.
It's not just the specifics. It's the whole damn thing, Dad. I feel like my life is rushing by. Completely out of control.
Oh, now you're back in familiar territory.
It's also overwhelming.
Listen, I know what you're feeling. I remember just like it was yesterday.
I think we can skip the male bonding thing. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Oh, and the Strokes choosing musical moment?
There is no on time for a show tune.
Okay, you stay here, I'll go in.
You think I'm frightened of a couple of dried up old men?
Okay, we'll open the doors on the count of three. Ready? One, two.
Can I be of service?
Amos, where the hell have you been?
It's a long story, Mom.
What's going on here?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Excuse me, Mom.
You look very handsome, dear.
Well, that's why I planned all this, so I could wear it.
I see.
Claire!
Nice to see you. Thanks so much for coming. Congratulations,
guys.
Way to go.
All right. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming.
Every dream, every wish, every want, every need that I've ever had is answered in your eyes, your heart, your hands. I am proud to stand before our family and friends to say, I love you.
Wow. I love you, too. I do. But what the hell are we doing here? I mean, big picture here, not here.
Yeah.
I know that we didn't get here alone. We owe our lives to the generations of gays and lesbians that struggled before us, some of whom gave up their freedom, others who gave up their very lives. I also know that it's up to us to do our very best to carry the next generation to where they need to be. Is this it? Is this equality? I don't know. I guess we have to trust that if what we've built here together can inspire this gathering, then we can't be too far off the mark. I love you, Andy. And I am nothing, if not yours.
Bye.
love this sissy shit. I want to know who knocked up my girlfriend.
Bingo, boys.
You're kidding! I knew you had it in you.
Trust, it's a good thing.
Okay, the bottom line seems to be our choice. We can embrace our differences and each stand alone, or we can accept the overwhelming evidence that none of us is so very unique and stand together on common ground. Thank you.